Innovation is the cornerstone of success in America. In order to compete in the global marketplace, businesses and individuals are continuously striving to stay ahead of the game. I'm Terry Bradshaw. You know, from emerging technologies and financial strategies to the latest healthcare developments, you would be surprised by the many factors coming into play. Welcome to Today in America. Here at the Ottawa Hospital Rehabilitation Center, also known as TOHRC, patients who have sustained a brain injury or an injury affecting mobility are benefiting from the latest advancements in virtual reality technology.
I think virtual reality rehabilitation therapy is really important. It's allowed me to bridge the gap between a controlled in-house physiotherapy and a very uncontrolled outside community.
As a therapist at TOHRC, Murray is well aware of the advantages of virtual reality in the rehab environment.
I think that the advantages of using virtual reality rehabilitation with the brain injury patients is that the patients can really get immersed into the activity and the environment is safe and they can extend and really push their limits when using the machine. I think that the Karen, being a stimulating environment, can be used not only for helping patients with their balance issues, but it can also help them with their cognitive issues. So, for example, helping them process information at a fast pace and being able to react to that environment.
The center uses the CARAM system by the Netherlands headquartered Motec Medical. Motec Medical specializes in the creation, design, and implementation of new technologies for the medical markets, focusing on diagnostics, rehabilitation, motor training, and research.
Motec Medical specializes in rehabilitation products, which are built to improve and speeden up rehabilitation processes. The CARAM system, that's the computer-assisted rehabilitation environment, and that's a virtual environment in which we can rehabilitate patients. People can move and have specific assignments in a virtual environment. In that case, you mimic the real life and you can let people experience rehabilitation processes with fun, but also with a serious underground.
Movable platforms, treadmills, motion capture devices, and visualization systems are integrated into one functional system that works in real time. The system enables researchers to analyze balance behavior, latency, response times, and relations between different sensory inputs that affect human decision protocols, human balance, human posture, and locomotion behaviors. 66-year-old Carl had a left above the knee amputation and numerous left arm injuries as a result of an IED while serving in Afghanistan.
The CARAM system has allowed Carl to learn how to use his prosthesis in different challenging environments. And the beauty of it is that you can modify the difficulty of the challenge depending on who's using the system. It's also a very safe system to use because when people are using it, they're harnessed. And also it's increased his confidence, I think, in using his prosthesis in different environments that he might encounter in real life.
The CARAM system will make a difference in my life, and it already has, and that I believe it'll allow me to have a life. If I don't learn how to walk with some proficiency with my prosthesis, I will end up in a wheelchair. And I don't see that as my future.
As America's baby boomers grow older, the CARAM system is expected to play a key role in their rehabilitation. Davout says it's all about seeing a need and providing a solution.